You can see right there, Las Vegas Metro is in the first steps of constructing a new training center. This is a map of where it will be. The new facility will help first responders across the state prepare for large-scale emergencies and events.
The idea started long before the 1 October shooting, but Metro says that night intensified the need for a training facility. Fox 5's Cassie Milnerick live from the future site in North Las Vegas with the details.
Yeah, it doesn't really look like much, but one day this is going to be the home of an all-new state-of-the-art training facility that's going to help not only Las Vegas Metro Police, but agencies across the state and even the country. Now, Metro Police says this is a game changer. It's going to allow first responders to prepare for real-life scenarios in a controlled but very realistic environment. A combined 160,000 square feet of realistic training scenarios. Everything an officer needs to prepare for a major event centralized to one location.
This facility will provide state-of-the-art training for individuals. Not just Metro, not just North Las Vegas, 80 law enforcement agencies throughout the state.
Las Vegas Metro Police started the idea years ago, but it never went from concept to reality until 1 October.
That horrific event highlighted the need for coordinated training for all first responders across the state.
That scenario, as it presented itself, is something that we're going to train for.
Phase one will cost $25 million. One building for classrooms, mat training, and simulators. Giving officers a chance to walk through realistic spaces, mimicking casino floors, school classrooms, a bank, a gas station, and more.
If you don't have a realistic environment with realistic events happening around you, your training takes on kind of a gaming mentality versus a realism.
The first phase will take about a year to complete. Phase two, an emergency vehicle operation center, will break ground shortly after.
Quite often people have great ideas and nothing ever comes of it, either because of lack of resources or money or anything else that goes along with those particular hurdles. But in this situation, I'm glad to see it's moving forward.
And Sheriff Lombardo attributes getting this project off the ground through private funding, which is actually going to pay for 100% of this project. But Metro says it still needs help. It has about $8 million to go. Reporting live, Cassie Milnerick, Fox 5 News, local Las Vegas.